De Verenigde Naties bestaat op 24 oktober 75 jaar. In dit kader wordt door lidlanden wereldwijd de VN-week gevierd en ook Suriname participeert hierin. Een der activiteiten, een storyline, waarin onder meer minister Albert Ramdin van Buitenlandse Zaken, International Business en Internationale Samenwerking aan het woord komt. Marina Walter, de UN-resident coördinator voor Suriname, zegt dat de VN meer dan 60 jaar een partner is om Suriname en haar bevolking te ondersteunen in hun ontwikkeling.
Het doel van de VN laat zich samenvatten als het nastreven van een wereld zonder oorlog en armoede en waar mensenrechten worden gerespecteerd. In de praktijk is dat natuurlijk een enorme uitdaging. Met het lidmaatschap van deze organisatie hebben de landen zich gecommitteerd aan de doelen en verplichtingen opgenomen in het Atlantisch Handvest van de Verenigde Naties, dat vergeleken kan worden met een internationaal verdrag waarin de basisprincipes voor internationale relaties zijn vastgelegd. Specifiek zijn de doelstellingen 1. Het handhaven van internationale vrede en veiligheid. 2. Het ontwikkelen van vriendschappelijke relaties tussen staten gebaseerd op respect, gelijke rechten en het zelfbeschikkingsrecht van volkeren. En 3. Fungeren als een centrum voor het harmoniseren van acties bij het streven naar de realisatie van de gemeenschappelijke doelen.
For more than 60 years, the United Nations has been a partner of Suriname and supported the people and the country on their path towards more sustainable and equitable development. Our journey together started in 1975, when Suriname joined the United Nations, standing proudly as a member state, shoulder to shoulder, co-equal with every other member state. Since then, we have witnessed and indeed been a partner in the growth and development of this country, which has become a distinguished member of the United Nations. Over the years, we faced many challenges together, and the United Nations has supported the country in tackling key issues across a whole number of areas. We have, for example, worked together to combat malaria, and Suriname is one of the few countries on the way to eradicating malaria in 2020. A massive step forward for the health of Suriname's population. We also worked on issues of food security over the years, supporting the country and its small farmers on developing a market for non-timber products, effectively combating deforestation. And we have worked closely with our partners in government and the civil society to ensure that the country's future is a green and a sustainable one. At the same time, as an organization, we strive to improve, trying to become a partner that is nimble, effective, and flexible on the ground. In 2019, we embarked on a reform of the UN's architecture to deepen our accountability in delivering meaningful results to our member states, including Suriname. This is the most ambitious reform of the UN development system in decades and aims to make the UN more agile, field-focused, and better coordinated. And it will allow the United Nations country teams to focus on collective results based on the needs and the priorities of Suriname. The UN reform, of course, went into effect just before the onset of a crisis, unlike any in our lifetime. COVID-19 is a crisis that has cut through our lives and our communities. And it demonstrated more than ever the importance of the work we are doing together, as the health crisis has now merged into a massive socio-economic crisis that challenges all countries around the globe, including Suriname. To support countries on this path to recovery, the United Nations partnered with the financial sector to create the Joint Sustainable Development Goal Fund as a critical component of our development response to accelerate the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals and to win back the development progress we lost in the recent months. Suriname just recently became one of only 62 countries around the globe that was awarded This critical funding to build an integrated national financing strategy to catalyze investments that leverage public and private financing into environmental solutions. As a resident coordinator of the United Nations system in Suriname, I want to reassure you that as partners, we stand ready to continue to support the country in these next crucial years as it responds to the pandemic, builds a strong recovery, combats increasing climate vulnerability, and implements the Sustainable Development Goals for sustainable economic growth, social inclusion, and environmental protection.